Hello everybody. In this video, I'm going to show you how arrays work in Java, and I'm going to illustrate that as we go along. An array is a compound data type that can hold many objects at the same time while providing easy access to the elements using indices. I'm going to be using a website called pythontutor.com, which surprisingly also supports Java. You can go and try your own programs for yourself on this website too to see exactly how the JVM executes your programs. Let me show you. Let's start by going to the website and click on Java. Then click on this tab to say render all objects on the heap. Then let's put in a little program and start executing that program. I'm going to make this a little wider. So the red arrow here indicates the line that's next to execute. And the first line here says we're declaring a variable A, which is an array of chars. Then we're assigning it a new array of chars with three elements. Notice here we're creating a new object. Let's execute. Over here you can see that A is now pointing to an array with three elements that are all containing zeros. So we can print out the length of the array using a.length. And correctly enough, the length is 3. Now, if we want to access an element, we have to use this notation. a.sub0, so a square bracket 0 square bracket. And that should print out the first element. Note here that the indexes start at 0, not at 1. And sure enough, 0 is right here, we just can't see it. But let's put some contents into the array. So first we'll assign A to the first element, and C to the third element, and B to the second element. Notice that we can access each element independently. The last element is at index length minus 1. See how the last element now became a Z. Moving along. I'm going to create a new variable that also holds a char array. And I'm going to assign it A. And here it is. So now B is assigned to A, which means B is now pointing to the same array as A is. And we can tell this. So if we print out an element, the third element is Z because we're pointing to the same array. And if we change something in using the B variable, you'll notice that the A array also changes because it's the same array. If we want to print out the entire contents of an array, we can do that very simply with a for loop. And there it is. Now, as you can tell, when we do assignment, we're simply assigning a reference to the array. We're not assigning a new array. To create a new array, we will have to create it ourselves. It's also known as a deep copy. Here's an example. We're declaring C to be a char array and assigning it a new char array of the same length as A. Then we use a for loop to copy each element separately. Let me show you. first creating a new array, which now contains just zeros. And then for each element, we're going to assign the value in the old array. And there you have it. So if we now compare the two arrays, if we use equals equals, we'll see that A and B are in fact the same object, whereas A and C are not the same object. They're not equal, despite having the same contents. And that's because they are separate arrays. And then I can prove that by changing something in the C array without changing the other array. This turns to M while the original array still has the original contents. Finally, there is a little complication when we're using regular objects, what's known as reference types, as opposed to primitive values, as we've seen. Let me create a new array that holds strings. You'll notice it says null here, which indicates that there is nothing here. It corresponds to the zero that was used for the primitive types. Let's assign some values. You'll notice that each one of the strings is another object, and therefore there's another reference going to them. But other than that, it works very much in the same way as the primitive types. So if I want to find out what the length of the third element of the array is, I just call .length the method, because it's an object. And there you have it, the length of the first string is 7. And that's pretty much all there is to arrays.